Right, we are going to continue with the problems of mathematics, and this is specially designed for people who are going to appear for their boards in the 10th standard examination this year. We are going to continue with some more problems which will actually clear your concept about basic things. So let's start off. Now, if m times the mth term of an AP is equal to n times its nth term, then show that m plus nth term of the AP is 0. Okay, so this seems to be a problem about AP. Let's see where it goes. So if m times the mth term of an AP is equal to n times the nth term. So what do we have here? If we just put first whatever is given to you, just try to put it up in small things and later expand it. So what do we have here? M times the mth term, as we denote the nth term by this, is equal to n times the nth term. This is what has been given to us. And what do we have to prove? To prove that the m plus nth term of the AP, that is tm plus n, is going to be 0. So let's now assume things. So let A be the first term and D the common difference of the AP. So if this happens to be the AP, A the first term and D the common difference of the AP, what do we have that mth term as? Obviously, it will be a plus m minus 1 into d. And what do we have that nth term is? A plus n minus 1 into d. We all know this, that these are the formulas for the m and the nth terms. In AP, we just have three formulas to remember. One is the term. The other one is the sum of terms. These are all that we have to remember. Okay, so this would be the m. Now we frame this equation here. So m into tm, which means a plus m minus 1 into d. So this will be equal to n into a plus n minus 1 into d. So what do we get here? Am plus m into d, and this will be m minus 1 into d. So if you notice, this has been multiplied by am. This m and d get multiplied. Okay, I'm sorry. So this m and this d get multiplied. We have m minus 1 is equal to a n plus n d n minus 1. A m plus m d m minus 1. A n plus n d n minus 1. So what do we have here? A m plus m square d minus m d. A n plus n square d minus n d. Okay, now we just have to ensure that we are getting different forms of m and n. So let's kind of bring all the m and n terms together. Now we see here am and we see here an. So let's transpose this term here. If we happen to transpose this term here, since at this end it is positive, when we bring it here, it will become negative. Again, we have here m square d. If we happen to bring this here, this will be n square d. Okay, now we have here md and this. So in this case, we just transpose this term that side. So we have here md. So since this was minus md, when it goes on that side, it becomes plus nd minus nd. So this will be d m minus n. M minus n into a plus m square minus n square into d. We are just taking out the common terms out here. So what do we get here? M minus n into a. This m square minus n square can be expanded as m minus n into m plus n into d, and this remains as m minus n into d. So if you look into this, we have got m minus n common, this common and this common. So we can get this entire thing divided by m minus n. So what do we have here? We have here as a plus m plus n into d is equal to d. This gets cancelled off. Now we bring this d this side. So this will be a plus m plus n d minus d is equal to 0. Obviously, if we bring this d here, nothing will be left here and we will be left with a 0. So this will be a plus m plus n minus 1. We are taking the d common. So this will be equal to 0. So this is what we get from the equation that was given to us. Now we have to find out the m plus nth term. So we know that m plus nth term can be given as a plus m plus n minus 1 into d. That's the general format of the nth term of an AP. So if this is the case, we know that the value of this is 1. So putting the value of from 1, putting the value from 1. So we get here tm plus n, this entire thing is 0. So hence we can say therefore the m plus nth term of the AP is 0. Always ensure that you finish your answer in a format that has been given to you. We generally make a mistake of finishing off our answers out here. Not that the examiners are going to be too strict on you, but it's generally this is called the etiquettes of mathematics. Whenever you are getting a concept out here, ensure that you finish off in the format. Obviously, tm plus n would be our assumption throughout the problem. It has never been given to us, or it has not been given to us in this problem. What has been asked to us is that you have to prove that the m plus nth term is equal to 0. So obviously this means that the m plus nth term is equal to 0, but your answer has to be in this format. So just ensure that you are writing the answers in the format that has been given to you, and you exclude the assumptions that you have made in the process. Tm is an assumption made by us, tm plus n is an assumption made by us, but what we need to write here is that m plus nth term of an AP is 0. That's the correct format of writing an answer. So this is going to have a very clear concept on the examiner's mind that you are thorough with the process, not only with the process but with the simple etiquettes of mathematics as well. So be sure about these things. We'll switch on to the next problem. Let's kind of get this started out here. So this was a problem which was purely on the concepts of arithmetic progressions. Okay, let's get started. From the quadratic equation, okay, again we have a problem from quadratic equations. Form the quadratic equation, whose roots are the squares of the sum of the roots and squares of the difference of the roots of the equation 2x square plus 2m plus n 2x plus m square plus n square is equal to 0. Now just understand this. This is a given quadratic equation. Obviously, this, if we correlate this, so ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. What do we get the value of a as? Very quickly, 2. What do we get the value of b as? 2m plus n. And what do we get the value of c as? M square plus n square. So these are the values that we get. Form the quadratic equation whose roots are the squares of the sum of the roots and squares of the difference of the roots of the equation. So let's form this equation now. Okay. Now we have to actually form a quadratic equation. How do we get this form? So we have this given equation, and from this we have to derive an equation. So first of all, let's calculate the roots of the equation. So alpha plus beta, what do we get here? Minus b by a. This is as per the sum of the roots of an equation. What do we have b as? Minus 2m plus n. What do we have the value of a as? Obviously a. So alpha plus beta is going to give you minus m plus n. So this becomes our basically first equation. This is our first equation. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus m plus n. Alpha beta, this is going to be c by a. what do we have the value of C as? M square plus n square. What do we have the value of A as? 2. So this is going to be m square plus n square by 2. So alpha beta, we have the value of m square plus n square by 2. So this is going to be the second information that we have. Now we will have to form an equation, as you can see, whose roots are the square. So let's assume, so let for the second, let the roots of the second equation be alpha dash and beta dash. Okay, so let's solve this now. So if we have alpha dash and beta dash, obviously alpha dash will be equal to, as it is said, whose roots are the squares of the sum of the roots. So one root is square of the sum of the roots, that is alpha plus beta square, and beta dash is going to be alpha minus beta square. Are we on the same page? See, whose roots are, so we are going to first find out the roots of the equation for which we have to frame an equation. So the roots of the equation alpha will be the sum of the roots of this equation, that is square of the sum of the roots, that is alpha plus beta square, and beta dash, difference of the squares of the roots. Alpha minus beta is square, squares of the difference of the roots, squares of the difference of the roots, square of the sum of the roots. Okay, so let's get this sorted out. So alpha dash, if we expand this, this will be alpha plus beta whole square, which means alpha plus beta has a value of, so alpha dash will be alpha plus beta whole square. Now alpha plus beta, as we have seen, has a value of minus 2 into m plus n by a, and this entire thing as square. So what do we get here? Minus gets cancelled, we have 4 m plus n square upon a square, or rather we have a as 2, sorry. So a will have a value of 2, we just put 4, this gets cancelled. So we have alpha dash as m plus n square. This is one root. Okay, now we'll switch on to beta dash. So beta dash here will be equal to alpha minus beta whole square. Now we know that alpha minus beta has not been given to us, but from alpha plus beta we can find it out. So we know that alpha plus beta whole square is equal to alpha square plus beta square plus 2 alpha beta, and alpha minus beta square is equal to alpha square plus beta square minus 2 alpha beta. If I happen to subtract this equation from this, so this will be alpha plus beta square minus alpha minus beta square. Obviously these two get cancelled. See, their signs are going to change. This is plus sign, so this is minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. This is going to change. So this will be 2 plus 2, that is 4 alpha beta. So what do we have here? If I transpose this term, alpha minus beta square, that side, and bring it on here, alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha beta. So this is what we get here as beta. So beta dash will be equal to alpha plus beta square minus 4 alpha beta. So beta dash will be equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha beta. Now we have to frame an equation. So the equation can be framed. How do we frame an equation? X square minus sum of roots into x plus product of roots is equal to 0. So this will be x square minus sum of roots, that is alpha dash plus beta dash plus product of roots, that's alpha dash beta dash, is equal to 0. So sum of roots here will be x square minus alpha dash plus beta dash. What's going, this is going to be m plus n square. We know that alpha dash has this value and beta dash has a value of, so beta dash will have a value of alpha minus beta square. If you check this out, so this will be alpha dash plus beta dash, which means m minus n square plus alpha beta, alpha dash beta dash, which will be how much? Alpha is having a value of m plus n square, and beta is having a value of m minus n square is equal to 0. So we will have here x square minus, what do we have? See, whenever we okay, let's expand this then. M square plus n square plus 2mn plus m square minus n square. So this will be minus alpha plus beta, minus 2 mn, and this is going to become plus m square minus n square whole square. As we can see, a plus b and a minus b, this square we take it out, and this will be m plus a plus b into a minus b, this will be m square minus n square. So this is going to be x square minus, what do we have here, m square plus n square, that's going to be 2m square, n square plus n square, that's going to be 2n square. This gets cancelled. We have here plus m square minus n square whole square is equal to 0. So if we kind of, this will be, taking out 2s common, this will be m square plus n square plus m square minus n square is going to be 0. This is going to be your equation for the second. So this is the equation. So the sum of the roots and the squares of the roots, this is the equation that we are required to form. So this is a purely a sum based on quadratic equations. However, the concepts of algebra like a square minus b square have been used very extensively out here. We'll move on quickly to the next sum. Okay, so what do we have again as sum on AP? Find if the sum of first P terms of an AP is equal to the sum of first Q terms, then show that the sum of its P plus Q terms is 0, where P is not equal to Q. So here we have, if the sum of the first P terms of an AP is equal to the sum of the first Q terms, then show that the sum of the P plus Q terms is 0. So we know that the sum of an AP is given by n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So the first thing that we'll do is let A be the first term and D the common difference of this AP. As I said earlier, whatever assumptions you are going to make in a problem, you are not going to give an answer in those assumptions. Those assumptions will be different. So let's kind of figure this out. So we have here the sum of the first P terms. Sum of the first P terms SP, this will be P by 2 into 2A plus P minus 1 into D. This is going to be your sum of first P terms is equal to the sum of the first Q terms SQ. So this will be Q by 2, 2A plus Q minus 1 into D. So what do we have to prove? Then show that the sum of the S, so SP plus Q, this is going to be 0. So let's first figure this out. Now SP, as per the given condition, is equal to SQ. So we have P by 2 into 2a plus p minus 1 into d is equal to q by 2, 2a plus q minus 1 into d. This gets cancelled, just multiply this, so we get 2ap plus pd into p minus 1, 2aq plus qd into q minus 1. Okay, so now we quickly have this here, 2ap, we transpose this term that side, so this will be minus 2aq. Okay, now we have plus p square d minus pd is equal to, we have already transposed this term, so we are left with q square d minus qd. So in this we can take 2a as common. So this will be 2a p minus q plus, if we happen to transpose this term here, p square minus q square into d is equal to p minus q into d. So we have here 2a p minus q plus p minus q into p plus q to d is equal to p minus q into d. So if we happen to divide this by p minus q, this will be 2a plus p plus q d is equal to d. If we happen to bring this here, this will be 2a plus p plus q d minus d is equal to 0. P plus q minus 1 into d is equal to 0. So what do we have here? 2a plus p, this becomes our equation number 1. Now we have to prove that sp plus q is equal to 0. So very quickly, if we happen to sp plus q, this will be p plus q by 2 into 2a plus p plus q minus 1 into d. Now we know that the value of this thing from 1, this will be p plus q by 2 into this entire thing is 0. So we get here sp plus q is equal to 0. So therefore sp plus q is equal to 0. Again, as I said, the answer is not going to be in this format. What we are going to write is, therefore, the sum of p plus q terms of the given AP is equal to 0. Always finish off your answer like this, because all these were our assumptions. So this gives us the sum of the this, hence it is proved. So again, this was a problem of AP. We have to be quick in grasping things. A lot of problems about arithmetic progressions are very much similar to this, as we sorted out an equation prior to this which was having conditions similar to the other one. So this was a lot of problems that we are dealing with. We will again finish off with some more problems to have a better picture of what we are dealing with.